Hey there, I'm Rye Myers, your Broadway and Entertainment BFF, and you're watching Live with Rye. Thanks so much for tuning in. Hey, I've got a great show for you today. But before we get to our special guest, as always, I have a huge favor to ask. If you're joining on YouTube, hit that subscribe button so you never miss an episode of Live with Rye, also for my Broadway talk show that I do in person. So subscribe to that YouTube channel right below. And hey, listen, if you got as much magic out of this as I did and you want to spread the magic, you can head to RyeTheNewsGuy.com/donate and make a donation, or you'll see my Venmo at the bottom of the screen as well. Thank you so much for your continued support. It means the world to me. And as you'll see at the bottom of the screen, RyeTheNewsGuy.com for all of my interviews and everything that I'm working on. And now I'm so excited to welcome today's guest. These two incredible guys are just wonderful. They have changed my life for the better. One of them who is just, I consider such a dear, dear friend and has truly, without him, I don't know where I would be. And I'm so thankful for him. We're revisiting, you may remember Nathaniel Hill, who I had on 20, one of my first few guests. So we have him back from Broadway Plus, and we're welcoming Tyce Green as well. Now that Broadway Plus and artists and none have merged together. So please help me welcome Nathaniel Hill and Tyce Green. Hey, Nathaniel.
Hello, hello.
How are you both?
Good.
Great. Thanks for having me back.
Oh, my pleasure. Yeah, you know, Nathaniel, you were one of the first guests that I had on this show, one of the first, like, three or four. So.
And look how far you've come.
Well, look how far I've come, look at how far you've come, which is, you know, when this company's come. Tyce, you're actually currently on tour right now, correct?
I am. I'm doing the tour of Jesus Christ Superstar.
Oh, that is amazing. I am dying to see that. I'm hoping it comes somewhere close to New York, Connecticut, or PA, because that's one of my favorite shows. And I hear it.
It's so good. It's an amazing, amazing production.
Is it? I've heard.
Nathaniel was there the night that I played Mary. Yeah.
And Ty sounds amazing. Andy has a great outfit.
Amazing. And you're Anais, right? Is that?
Anais.
Awesome. Well, definitely go see Jesus Christ Superstar. So, alrighty. So obviously, Nathaniel, you run Broadway Plus, and Tyce, you're now one of the partners. For those who may not know, and if you don't, I don't know where you've been, but how did Broadway Plus get started? For those who may not remember, how did it get started and how did it come about?
Sure. Well, now that we're partners, Tyce and I run the company together. It definitely takes two of us. I started what is Broadway Plus in 2016, so 6 years ago. I actually was doing a business certificate program at Columbia University, and our homework was to come up with an idea for a business. And my idea was to do a travel agency focused on Broadway shows, which morphed into the idea of creating VIP experiences in terms of ticketing for Broadway shows. So I noticed when you went to buy tickets to a concert, there was always a slew of VIP and meet and greet options. And I knew that we didn't have any of those for Broadway. Because I was working on the ticketing and management side, I sort of understood why we didn't have those for Broadway. And so that was the problem that I set out to solve. And I slowly, over the course of a year, year and a half, created a mechanism that shows could use to, and a company that shows could use to sell and fulfill VIP experiences for Broadway, which typically included a great seat and a meeting with one of the stars of the show.
Wow. And truly talk about knowing where there was a gap that needed to be filled, and you certainly filled that. What an incredible, incredible mind to have had and to have been able to fill that, you know, because a lot of people clearly until you came along and thought of it, nobody did. So it takes special people to think of stuff like that.
Well, I was young and didn't know any better.
Oh, you're still young. So Tyce, how did you and Nathaniel meet and come about? And how did you come on board here?
So like Nathaniel, pre-pandemic, I was also running my own business and doing something totally different. Well, I shouldn't say totally different, but different. During the pandemic, we both pivoted separately to a virtual platform and we were competitors in like the one-to-ones lesson space for Broadway, for booking like, you know, individual lessons for Broadway artists. And it was Nathaniel that reached out, I think on Instagram, and started this conversation. And I didn't know what to expect. And he flew down to Houston, where I live, and we went out to my favorite restaurant, and it was great. It's the best thing that the best thing that could have ever happened, because there is, Nathaniel and I talk about this a lot. It is, not only is it rare to find like a niche in, you know, an industry, and then be able to be very accomplished at that, which is something that Nathaniel and I have done separately. But to find somebody in the same industry who shares the same goals with you, has the same amount of integrity, and is also somebody that you like and get along with and can have a great personal relationship with and a great business relationship with. I mean, that doesn't happen, you know, or I should say when it does, like the rarity of that are reasons why, you know, why people like you are like, let's interview both of you. You know, and I just think it's important when, you know, whenever we talk about like the success of the company and about like the amazing things that the company does, obviously, it very much is a testament to the integrity that Nathaniel and I have, and how well we work together, because we instill that every single day in for all the people that, all the employees that work for Broadway Plus, as well as the artists. That was sort of a long sorted way, basically, of I answered like 10 questions that you didn't ask, right? But that's why this happened, and that's why it worked, was because the combination of all of those things all happened to come together. And it's very possible that this would have happened even if some of those things weren't there, but there really wasn't a box that was checked. So it was a no-brainer.
Well, a no-brainer indeed. And as you said, it's about integrity. And you mentioned, you know, relaying this to your staff, you know, you do that with your staff. I mean, Nathaniel, since we last chatted, it's been over a year and a half, almost 2 years of growth for you. You know, when we were chatting, it was in the fall. Everything was going digital. You had a small like staff, I think it was 4 or 5 people. We were doing Broadway Plus experiences virtual. Afterwards, you know, a funny little story, Nathaniel was like, hey, can you help host a few events? And I said, sure. And a few turned into, now I'm one of the main hosts at Broadway Plus and have hosted several events, which has been wonderful. But now you have a large staff, a beautiful office in Midtown. I mean, it's just been a year of growth for both of you. What does that feel like? That must be so rewarding to have this growth in such a short amount of time. Nathaniel?
Yeah, there's no question. It feels amazing. I mean, I love what we do. I love connecting people all around the world with my favorite type of person in the world, a Broadway artist. So it's just so rewarding. You know, I used to be able to work only with people who were coming to New York City, and for the most part, spending more than $500. And so now with our Zoom platform, with having more staff, with absorbing Tyce's expertise, which was more in the education and student-driven field, we reach thousands of people most days, and there's nothing more rewarding than going from reaching 3 people a day to 1,000. That's for sure. And we work hard. We're able to attract amazing employees who are just as passionate about we are and who are here for all the right reasons, which is really great. And we work hard to take care of the artists who choose to work with us. And that's always our priority. You know, clients are great, but we're nothing without the artists that choose to work with us. So we spend a lot of time and energy making sure that we're providing an amazing experience for them as well. And Allie, the one employee that I have now that was with me before the pandemic, you know, she said to me, she was actually doing an interview recently, and she said, we make it more sustainable and more practical to be a Broadway artist because we give people a way to make a living through what they do. at a time, you know, perhaps during a time when they don't have regular income coming in. And yes. I never thought of it quite that way. And that really struck me and made me feel great.
well, let's continue that because yeah, you know, I mean, Broadway Plus, and I'm not just saying this, I mean, I think it saved people's lives. It helped so many artists during the brunt of the pandemic when everything was closed. So many artists who were able to be on the Broadway Plus platform and give classes or coach or teach. And, you know, once Tyce, you came on board, then the classes started happening and there was master classes with all the like these crazy, awesome Broadway people, and artists were being able to work in a time when there was nothing happening. So that also has to feel amazing that both of you were able to contribute, you know, whether it was, you know, a few jobs here and there, or there was artists who were working week after week in a time when there was no art to be made. You guys were making it happen.
I think to Nathaniel's point about the sort of revelation about how we maybe improve is giving us too much credit, but Allie's point about like Allie telling Nathaniel about how basically we can expand on somebody's the financial end of somebody's career as a Broadway artist. You know, that's basically what we're doing, and I think that it's a testament to our skills and the skills that we have of our staff that we have attracted. I can't tell you how many times a day that we create a gig out of nothing, you know, and we will. It's sort of our job to kind of go out and find all of the people that are interested in Broadway and communicate to them in a way that is relatable and lets them know that they can trust us and that we're going to create some kind of experience. We're going to listen to what they want. There's so many Broadway lovers out there. Everybody from just one person living in rural Ohio all the way up to big wigs at big companies that are like, we want Broadway artists to come out and talk to our staff and stuff like that. We connect every single kind of Broadway lover, and we try to problem solve every single day on what are those people wanting, and how can we get them that? I mean, that's kind of the bare bones of what we do. It's all about going out and finding people that love Broadway and just making sure that they can have it, whether they are in New York City or whether there's a shutdown or whether they live in Hawaii.
We have a map of the world in the office. I love maps, so I got us this map, and we put a pin in all the places in the world that we've worked with a client from. And it's pretty cool. We have Indonesia now, we have Singapore and Brazil and of course Australia. And it's wild to think about, you know, something we did together and something that's such a New York based art form having such a reach. It's really, really exciting.
Such a wide reach. And Tyce, since you've come on as a partner, now working with Nathaniel, what are you sort of work on day to day? Are you still bringing sort of that education that came over from Artists and Beyond, or do you work, is it more now your focus on more businessy side? What have you brought over that you work on day to day now as a partner?
I mostly sweep the floors. No.
Yes, that's true. Last time I was there, you were doing that.
Get out of town. Actually, maybe rearrange the furniture. That's just a hobby. Much to Nathaniel's dismay. It's a combination of all those things. You know, what was so great about our collaboration was that the reason that we did this was because if two people who were doing two separate things could have the same idea to pivot to the same thing, then you've got that you know, that sort of thing that we pivoted to as connective tissue. But all of the things that Nathaniel was doing pre-pandemic, all the things that I was doing pre-pandemic, the thing that we pivoted to in the middle, and then the combination of all those things and what ideas those things sprouted is what the company has turned into. And more specifically to your question, I spend a lot of time, there is a huge education element to it. And as we've combined, you know, we've been able to expand resources to reach out to more educators. But we spend a lot of time talking about all the different parts of the company. So Nathaniel and I are just kind of like the the two the two little guys. What's it in the Muppets where they got the two old guys like sitting in the balcony, like whatever.
Oh yeah, I forget their names.
Yeah. I know, I don't know what their names are, but no, that's kind of what we're doing. No, yeah, I mean we're both involved in every single aspect of the company. We wear a million different hats. You know, I with Artists and Beyond, I had on the social media side, when the pandemic happened, I was like, well, everybody's on social media, so let's see if we can do something on social media. So I spent 8 hours a day on Instagram and didn't sleep, and figured out just by doing it, and being in the DMs with people, just kind of listening to them and hearing what they wanted. And we had built up this small but mighty following on the Artists and Beyond account, and it was done without any advertising at all. It was just organic following and word of mouth. And so when Broadway Plus acquired A&B, one of my first things was, I was like, we've got to get on this social media trend. And I think when I joined, there was about 10,000 followers on somewhere between like 7 and 10 on the Broadway Plus Instagram. And now I'd have to check, but I think on Instagram we're 45,000, and wow. we had I don't know, 100 on TikTok, and now we were at 146,000, I think, on TikTok.
Yeah, 148.3 on Instagram, 48,000.3.
But again, I mean, I can't emphasize enough how much of an extension of our skills is our staff, right? So being able to be two really great collaborators and have the skills that we bring, part of being a tactful businessman is being able to go, okay, I've got these skill sets. How can I find a dedicated person to be able to pass that skill set on to? And, you know, I would say Nathaniel and I spend a lot of time and have spent a lot of time dedicating our time to, like, you know, when we have a new person, like we really spend the time to make sure that they learn what we know how to do. And it's also listening to what they know how to do that we don't, you know, and listening to their ideas that can expand upon the ideas that we have. I'm a firm believer in listening to ideas from everybody, from the intern all the way up to the highest of the high, you know, because you just never know when that one idea will turn into something. And it's happened for us. Every single person in our company, including the interns, have all had stellar ideas.
Yeah. It's important to listen to people and to, you know, to have that. And it's a great, great business model. I commend both of you. As we start to wrap up here, you know, sort of a final question is, short-term goal, where do you see Broadway Plus going in a five-year goal? What do you hope for Broadway Plus? Is there sort of something that is in the close rearview mirror that you hope sort of in the next 5 years? Nathaniel, start with you.
Well, as Broadway continues to return, we brought back the VIP service division. We have a group sales license now, which means if you have more than 10 people going to a show and you work with us, we can help you access a discount. That had been a very long-term goal of mine that we finally achieved in 2021. So that's really thrilling. And the last 2 years were, as you can imagine, a very, very wild ride of a lot of downs and ups and a lot of hiring great people, like Tyce was just saying, and I wasn't really sure what they were going to do, but then developing and adapting their position and the company to fit their strengths. And so I feel like that was definitely a phase that went all the way through 2021, but is now over. And now we have an amazing company and we have the ability to work with twice as many people as we're working with right now, I would say. So we are, you know, working on larger scale partnerships to bring in more people, educate them. What is Broadway Plus? Yes, it's real. You can actually book your favorite Broadway star and talk to them next week. They can come to your school. They can Zoom with your class. It's all real. And if you want to go see a show, we can help you with that too. So I think it's about increasing our brand awareness and our reach, as opposed to increasing our capabilities, which we did for most of the last 2 years.
Yeah, certainly have. That's great. I love that. Well, was there anything you wanted to add to that, Tyce?
No, we're making dreams a reality, just like Nathaniel said.
Yes, you are. You are making dreams a reality. Well, as we wrap up here, where can we keep up with Broadway Plus and get all of the good news from Broadway Plus for those who maybe don't know or don't know where to keep up? Where can we find you?
You can find us at BroadwayPlus.com. You can find us at Broadway Plus. Oh, look at that. It's so fast. You can find us at Broadway Plus on social media, Twitter, Instagram.
Newly verified.
Oh, you got all that. You got
T-Y-C-E.
Oh, for me, yes. You can find me at T-Y-C-E. Nathaniel, are you giving away yours or no?
I'm not an influencer like you, but it's N.W. Hill if you care.
Nathaniel is an influencer, and he has the best vacation photos in my opinion. Nobody knows how to. It's worth mentioning actually that if you do follow Nathaniel, he just recently skydived, and while I would never ever do that in a million years, he got like a GoPro video of it, and it's one of the coolest things I've ever seen.
Yes, he did.
My initial concept was a travel agency for Broadway, so my Instagram is mostly travel and sadly not Broadway.
Well, and you love travel. You love travel, so check it out if you love travel for sure. I mean, you post some great things. You know how to take great pictures, I'll tell you that. And for those of you watching, if you want to follow me and keep up with me, I'm at Rye_Myers. That's Rye with an E, like Wiza with a Z, on Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter. And Official Rye Myers on Facebook as well. Okay, well, listen, Tyce, Nathaniel, thank you so much for chatting with me today. What an incredible 2 years, really, almost, this has been, Nathaniel. I mean, when we first chatted, Broadway Plus was doing great things, but boy, have they skyrocketed. And just on a personal note, thank you for all that you've done for me and believing in me and helping me during the pandemic to have a reason to believe. In being able to host events in what I love, Broadway, and being able to help that, be a small part of helping that with others, who truly changed my life and helped me in some of these darkest periods. So thank you.
Thanks for being a part of our community, and congrats on all your success as well.
Amazing. Thank you.